Doctors reported today on a new weapon in the fight against cancer, one that does not use drugs or radiation, but enlists the patient's own body to attack cancer cells. We asked Dr. John LaPook to tell us more.
At 35, Erica Wallace learned she had advanced cervical cancer that had spread to her lymph nodes.
It just kind of became, all right, just deal with it. Tell me what I need to do because I'm a mom and I need to be here for my boys.
Intensive chemotherapy did not work. The Wallaces were told Erica had about a year to live.
I had to discuss, what if I'm not here? You know, what's going to happen with the boys? Because I could feel I was getting weaker, and so I was pretty rock bottom at that moment.
Just 2 months later, she became patient number two in a small trial using the body's immune system to seek out and destroy metastatic cervical cancer. Dr. Christian Hinrichs at the NIH Clinical Center leads the trial.
The treatment that we do, we completely rearrange the immune system.
Doctors take a piece of the tumor and extract specialized white blood cells, or T cells. Those are tumor-fighting cells sent by the body's immune system to target the cancer. The T cells most potent against cervical cancer are selected and grown in the lab. Billions of these cells are then infused into the patient's bloodstream.
The idea is to give a single treatment and have the cells wipe out the tumor the same way that they would clear an infection.
6 of 9 patients in the study had no response, and 1 had a partial response. 2 had complete remission. Wallace was one of those 2. This is a scan from her checkup last week. Nearly 2 years after treatment, there is no sign of cancer. Earlier this year, her younger son, Marcus, had a chance to meet the research team.
He looked at them and said, thanks for saving my mom. And that's what NIH has done, is saved me.
Although only 2 of 9 patients were successfully treated, Dr. Hinrichs says this is the first time this kind of therapy has provided a long-term remission in somebody with cancer of the cervix. The hope is to use this same approach for other solid tumors, such as breast, lung, and colon.
Which would be remarkable. Dr. John LaPook, thank you.